Setting up the HSI card is easy. Here we have a new project, and we're online with the controller. Step 1, auto-discover the hardware. Click on the hardware configuration, and then read the configuration. Remember, you have to be in stop mode to read the configuration. The software is now going to tell us all the new modules it found. We know that, we'll just say yes to all. We now have a fully populated system with a local base and a remote base with our HSI and HSO cards. Step 2, configure the HSI module. Double click on the HSI module, give it a name. How about HSI demo? We have our tooth counting Prox sensor connected to channel 2A, so let's make a note of that. And our index proximity sensor is connected to 2Z. Note that you can't use 2B for counting pulses. It's strictly used for direction, like when we're using encoders, for example. We're not going to use direction in this example, so it's okay just to leave it blank and unconnected. We also want to use output 2 to drive our strobe light, so let's call that Prox strobe. We're not going to use channel 1 yet. The encoder is connected to that one, so let's go straight to channel 2. The software is telling me I defined some new tags, and it's asking me if I want to create them. Sure. I really like that it does that for me, so I'll have to fool with it later. Let's name this channel Tooth Counter. And since we want to count teeth, let's change our units to teeth. And we'll get one pulse per tooth, so we don't need to change that. Even though that didn't change anything, the cool part is, now all of our units going forward will be in teeth. I love that feature. It makes things so much easier. Plus, it's really going to help us in our second example when we use the encoder. Our current position is really a count of teeth, so we'll call that tooth count. Note the units are all set up for us, and our velocity will be tooth velocity. Again, the units are all set up. Finally, tooth status is our status. We're counting pulses. This isn't an encoder, so we want to make sure that pulse and direction is selected. And we're done. So all we did was name the channel, change our units, define some tags, and make sure we're counting pulses. Hit OK. Let the Productivity 3000 create the tags for us. And close the hardware dialog. Well, that's all there is to setting up the HSI. Step 3, it's time to use it. Let's bring up the registration instruction from our high-speed instruction palette here. Right there, I'm going to drop him on rung 1 and fill in the blanks. We want our tooth counter channel. We use trigger group 1. We want to trigger everything on that index proximity sensor. Rising edge is fine. Since each index hit is one rotation of the sprocket, we'll create a sprocket count tag that'll keep track of the number of rotations of that sprocket. When we see that index hole, we're going to delay the registration by the number in this tag. Note that our custom units are in place already. Then after that delay, we want to pulse our strobe light, let's say for 1 millisecond. Let's do one more thing. Let's go ahead and create a tooth progress. That'll tell us whether the process is enabled or not. And let's go ahead and create a tooth status. So if we get any errors, we'll know immediately. Well, that's all we need for now. We chose the correct channel. We're triggering on that index proximity sensor. We're keeping track of how many hits we get. We're going to delay the registration action by the number in this tag. And after we do the delay, we're going to pulse our LED strobe. We'll say OK. We'll add the new tags to our database. And all we have to do now is enable our instruction. I've already added a normally open contact here, which is connected to switch 16 on my input simulator. That way I can just reach over to the P3 and enable this instruction manually. Let's transfer that to controller. And we're ready to go. Before we get started, let's do one more thing. I'm going to go back in this instruction and say monitor. That's going to create a data view for me. It's going to monitor all those tags we created. Let's bring up our data view so we can see those tags. Now we know we can't have a delay of 0, so I'm going to put in a delay of 30 teeth. I'll write that out. I'm going to reach down and flip switch 16 on my input simulator. And now I see that my instruction is running because my in-progress flag went to a 1. I'm going to reach over with my hand and move the sprocket. And sure enough, I can see the registration input toggle. And my sprocket count is increasing as I rotate the sprocket. Let's go ahead and fire up the VFD. And I'll bring our strobe light up. And sure enough, we can see our little smiley face frozen in time. If I change the tooth delay, oh, let's say 24, and write that out, then boom, instantly the smiley face moves and we're now monitoring a different tooth in the process. So remember what's happening here. The index hole was detected by this Prox sensor, but then the registration activity was delayed by, in this case, 24 teeth, and we're now seeing that index hole rotated all the way around over here with this green strobe light. And note that this is completely independent of motor speed. If I reach down and change the speed, you can see that smiley face stays right there. The best part is, even though all of this is going on, the Productivity 3000 CPU doesn't have to worry about keeping up with all of this registration and counting and velocity stuff. The values are just sitting there ready for it to use however it wants, just like any other tag in the system. Even if it's happening on a remote base like we have here. That's really cool because you don't have to go fetch the data or manipulate it or anything. It's just sitting there ready to use. Could we have done the same thing using the encoder instead of the Prox sensor? Sure. Check out part 3 to see the exact same example, but using an encoder instead of the proximity sensors to do the sensing. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series for more ways to get up and running quickly with this controller. And as always, please send us any comments you may have. We appreciate the feedback. Performance plus value. That's productivity from Automation Direct.